What do they base their religion? قال الله قال الرسول فهم الصحابة. So أهل البدعة, three, right? Number one, they عقول أو آراءهم, their intellect. Number two, they're the language, they base it on the language. And number three, they base it upon their أهواء, their desires. أما أهل السنة والجماعة, the book of Allah, the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the companion, and then they will bring about the Arabic language. And then they bring about the Arabic language. But they will not take the Arabic language over what? The fahm of the Sahaba. They will not bring the Arabic language over the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They will not bring the Arabic language over the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this was, barakallahu fikum, the statement of the Shaykh rahimahullah rahmatan wasiha. So from the Lajna to Daima, they went to say, وَمِنْ أَدِلَّةِ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْأَعْمَالِ دَاخِلَةِ فِي حَقِيقَةِ الْإِيمَانِ وَعَلَىٰ زِيَادَتِهِ وَنُقْصَانِهِ بِهَا. From those evidences to prove that indeed the actions, they are dakhilatun, they are inclusive. The actions are indeed inclusive in the reality of iman. They are inclusive in the reality of iman. And likewise, for the ziyada, the increase, and likewise the decrease. In regard, all of them, they are, barakallahu fikum, the adillah. So here, the first one that he mentioned, hafidhahumullah, aw rahimahumullah, قول الله تبارك وتعالى إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون أولئك هم المؤمنون حقا. Look at this verse. In regard to this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing to us who? The believers. Right? The believers, meaning those who have what? Al-Iman. He described them indeed. Truly the believers, the true believers are those who, إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ, if they are being reminded about Allah, وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ, that their hearts is, any tremble or is shaken, right? Is shooked. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ. And when the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being recited to them, زَادَتْهُمْ, it will increase them in what? إِيمَانًا, in their belief. It will increase them in iman. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. And they, unto their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, they put their trust. So here we have what we have in the verse. We have إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ, when Allah is being mentioned to them, when they're being reminded about Allah, right? When they're being reminded about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that their heart is tremble with fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ, and if they have been recited unto them, آيَاتُهُ, the verses of Allah, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, it will increase them in what? In belief. So here are actions, barakallahu fikum. The admonishment, right? When they have been reminded, that's an action, barakallahu fikum. And when the verses of Allah are being read to them, it's another action. That will increase them in their iman. You all remember, the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, when we all in that point, he say, that remembering Allah increase what? Iman. And likewise, وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ, and when the verses of Allah are being recited to them, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, when the verses of Allah are being recited to them, they what? They increase in iman, in faith. So reciting the verses of Allah does what? Increase the belief. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, and unto their Lord they put their trust. Who are those again? الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَىٰ, They establish the salah. So they are believers based on this action that they're doing. Right? They are believers based on this action that they're doing. So they establish the salah. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ Those who establish and perform the salah. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ And from that which they have been given or provided for, that they spend on that. They spend from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided them. So all of this is actions. Establishing the salah, it is action, right? It is what? It is ibadah that is? Huh? Badi, na'am, it is ibadah that is badani. Right? It is badani. Barakallahu feek. And likewise, he mentioned, and when that, on that which they have been given, that they will spend on that which they were being provided with. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he mentioned, الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ those who perform the salah, establish the salah, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ that what they have been provided, they spend on their wealth. أُولَٰئِكَ such ones, هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّا they are the true believers. They are the true believers. Now all of these things that was mentioned in this verse, Barakallahu Fikum, they were all actions. They were all actions. Spending in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has yani blessed them with, has given them, establishing the salah. And likewise, Barakallahu Fikum, reading the Quran and listening to the admonishment. It's an action. And all of it is a proof of iman. It is a proof of iman, and it is part of iman, as inshallah ta'ala he will say on the other section of the dars, inshallah. Exactly, barakallahu feekum. That here also, as the brother mentioned, that Allah Jalla Ala mentioned that when they've been reminded that their hearts, right, the hearts is being what? Will be trembling out of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So also, al-khushu wal-khawf, here, on this verse. It is from the amalul qalb, it is from the actions of the heart. And we, alhamdulillah, we had mentioned this verse in the very first, when he was establishing what? The? Ahsant al-adilla ziyadat al-iman. When he was mentioning about the adilla, the verses or the proof, to show that iman increases. Alaykum salam wa barakatuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in describing the believers, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ Successful are the believers. Successful are the believers. As if, right? Allah knew that people want to know who are the believers. What are their criteria? What are their characteristics? What are their sifat? What are their description? Right? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ Successful are the believers. And now he started mentioning who are the believers. And you point, Barakallahu Fikum, on the action that is being mentioned in this. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ Those who they have al-khushu in their salah. They have this utmost level of concentration in their salah. طيب لا يلتفتونَ يعني يميناً وشمالاً They are not be turning left and right. Or anybody comes in, they want to know who comes in the likes of this. Or looking at their watch or taking their, whatever the case, things like this. That is of what? Distraction. أحسن الله عليك.
Say it one more time.
In your statement, you said, when you first recite this ayah, you said, it's as if Allah knew the people would inquire who are the believers.
Okay.
So I was just reminding with that statement, Allah did knew the people, right? When you say, it's as if Allah knew the people would ask. So it's like maybe Allah, based on the way you said it, when you say it's as if Allah did new people's gonna ask.
Because I don't wanna make
a affirmation that is there.
Right?
No, I want to be cautious to say about what I have a proof for. Even though it is true. Allah knows everything.
No.
But I don't want to say something that nobody preceded me. That's why I use if. You understand?
Yeah,
Barakallahu fi. I want to be cautious of what I say. Right? very point, good point, Barakallahu fi. Now, Allah knows everything. Right? So now, if a person say, why do you say this? I say, Akhi, I didn't make a affirmation. I did not make an affirmation. Right? I didn't make an affirmation. It was what? What you call? It is? When you use if in a sentence, what you call that? Very good. So mean, like say, it's hypothetical. Right? That's the difficult word. That's why I was cautious about to say that, right? So here he mentioned, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, that indeed successful are the believers, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ, those who are يعني well concentrated in their, have خشوع in their salah, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ, those who turn away from vain talk, right? Those who turn away from vain talk, they will not be part of some vain talk. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ, those who they fulfill and give their zakat. They give their zakat. So that's also action. So we have how many so far?
Three.
Number one was? Yes, very good. Action of the heart, yes.
And the prayer
too. You got both of them. You got the salah, right? And you got also the khushu, which is only the khushu is, the heart is doing it. The khushu is not the action of the tongue. The khushu is not action of the eyes, but rather it is the action of the heart. A person can be in his salah, right? You think that he's very well concentrated, but he's gone. Long gone. Huh? It's possible. A person can be very, you know, like you think that he's physically, yes, that's the word. Physically, he is like you think that this man is, subhanallah, you would have stabbed him, he would not feel it. But he is all over the place, right? So that was number one. So we have two. You have the salah itself and the khushu, that is the action of the heart. So you have the salah, which is the action of the body limbs. And you have the khushu, that is the actions of the heart, the action of the heart. So after that, he mentioned what? وَالَّذِينَ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ, that they are what? Turning away from اللَّغْوُ vain talk. So they do not partake on it. They don't partake on it. They don't be doing what? Not only they don't say it, but they don't even witness it. Not only they don't say it, but they don't even witness it. So refraining from vain talk is also from the action of the tongue, and likewise the action of the body limbs, because the ears, they are from the body limbs. So he mentioned, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِمْ أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ. He mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala went to say, he say, وَالَّذِينَ, and those whom لِفُرُوجِهِمْ, that their private part, they safeguard it. They safeguard their private part. Except towards their wives or their right hand possess. Or except their wives, unto their wives, or their right hand possess. Right? Is it something that is still existing? As'alukum. Huh? The right hand possess. Is it something that is still existing?
I don't know.
Not that one. Huh?
In the Sharia?
What is that?
Kumo Marando.
Kumo
Marando. Yeah. Malakati Aymanu.
The right hand possess, is something that still exists? That's a question I'm asking.